Oggi saliremo a bordo di un super yacht e faremo qualcosa di diverso dal solito, qualcosa di...
Today we will board a super yacht and do something a little different, something special. We won't worry about the luxurious furnishings, but instead the technology. We want to show you how Rolls-Royce have been able to make maneuvering a 38-meter ship easier and how they managed to make the 200 tons of the Bernetti Fast 125 Fly on the water.
Sappiamo che i mezzi navali più agili sono i rimorchiatori.
We know that tugs are the most agile vessels, and the Bernetti Fast 125, designed and built by Rolls-Royce, was developed from these professional propulsion systems. Rolls-Royce designed the Azipul Carbon 65 propulsion system for this super yacht. It's a lightweight, steerable thruster with a high-performance pulling propeller. It is made of carbon fiber, even its structural parts, to considerably reduce its weight and so does not dramatically affect the ascent of the hull depending on its position. Then we keep in mind that the immersed part, due to its size, also receives a vertical force equal to the volume of water displaced, and we can consider this effect as a reduction of its weight.
Si tratta di un pod drive, cioè di un macchinario che trasforma il moto orizzontale in uscita.
It's a pod drive, a machine that transforms the horizontal motion exiting the engine into vertical motion to descend under the hull, and then again in horizontal motion to turn the propeller in a direction that is perfectly parallel to that of the hull, in order to have maximum efficiency. Let's consider that the traditional shaft lines are generally inclined downwards and therefore waste part of the thrust in a direction that is useless to the motion of the ship. The transmission system works with two sets of spiral bevel gears. The steering is done thanks to a hydraulic system. The bearings and the support structure are covered by a patent. Everything is controlled by a Rolls-Royce Marine electronic control unit. The yacht's draft, pod drive included, is just under 2 meters. With this propulsion system, the engine room is compact and more space can be given to the cabins. And then it is set back aft, and this has influenced the comfort level. In fact, moving the engines aft, they managed to insert the garage between the engine room and the cabins. The Bernetti Fast 125 is equipped with two MTU engines. They are 2000 series model M94 V16s, 2636 horsepower each.
Questa è la plancia di comando del Bernetti Fast 125.
This is the control panel of the Bernetti Fast 125. And these are the controls of the engines and of the propulsion. To accelerate, it's enough to move this part of the lever forward, while to direct boat with a slow motion, this command is rotated.
When
maneuvering, the overall bar angle is 70 degrees, while in navigation it varies according to the speed, and it reduces the faster you go, from 20 to 8 degrees.
Per le manovre si può utilizzare anche...
For maneuvers you can also use the joystick, which simultaneously controls both the engines and the bow thruster. 38 meters of a ship like this can rotate on the spot and even move laterally with this command.
Lo stesso sistema può funzionare anche da ancora virtuale, cioè tenere l'imbarcazione ferma.
The same system can also work as a virtual anchor. It can keep the boat stationary in the middle of the sea in a certain position. Without doing anything, the propulsion system will take care of correcting any changes in course or movement due to wind or current.
La potenza dei motori al 50%.
I brought the power of the engines to 50%. Engine speed is 1160 RPM. The speed is 10.8 knots. But what is extraordinary is the consumption. Less than 50 liters per hour per engine.
Siccome il consumo globale è di 100 litri ora, potremmo dire...
As the global consumption is 100 liters per hour, we could say that with a tank capacity of 30,000 liters, you could sail for 300 consecutive hours. But we must also add the consumption of the generators that serve to power all the electrical users on board. As their consumption is 50 liters per hour, we have a total of 150 liters per hour, which means that with 30,000 liters, we can sail for 200 consecutive hours, and at 12 knots, travel 2,400 miles without a stop.
Se volessimo però scegliere una velocità di crociera un po' più alta, beh.
But if we wanted to choose a slightly higher cruising speed, well, just give a little more fuel to the engines. Let's take them to around 70% of power and see what happens.
Sullo schermo davanti a me ho l'indicazione.
On the screen in front of me, it shows the indication of the azipull. Here, look, now I'm changing course and they are moving. It's really amazing how they can change in a very short time the direction of the hull. The control is very precise. I would say that you can regulate the route manually by 1 degree. The first azipull was mounted in 2003, and today more than 550 have been installed. There are models for commercial ships, such as ferries for transporting vehicles and people. The azipull has the propeller in front of the transmission, then receives a non-turbulent flow of water, which reduces cavitation and, consequently, the vibrations on board the yacht. The exhaust of the engines is ejected underwater from the backside of the pod drive and minimally contributes to the push. We are continuing our journey from Spezia to Viareggio.
Con questa percentuale di carico a 1780 giri minuto, navighiamo a.
With this load at 1780 RPM, we sail at 14.6 knots. Consumption, of course, has risen. We are at about 190 liters per hour per engine. But it is already extraordinary that such a superyacht can sail at such a high speed and can do even more.
Abbiamo cominciato in dislocamento, ma con questo yacht.
We started in displacement, but with this yacht you can also go very fast. It's like having two boats in one. Now let's bring the engines to their maximum power. Oh, the bow starts to rise.
A 2450 giri minuto la velocità è...
At 2450 RPM the speed is 22 knots, but be careful. To this yacht's 200 tons, we have to add another 40 because we have a full tank of fuel and a full tank of water at this moment.
A carico leggero, la velocità massima raggiunta da...
Light, the maximum speed reached was 24 knots. The data is here.
Le eccellenti prestazioni sono anche il risultato della leggerezza.
The excellent performance is also the result of the lightness of the Benetti Fast 125, which, due to its construction features and its propulsion system, is at the top of the mega yacht field.